In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. And welcome everybody to the celebration of Holy Mass this morning. Together we gather on this second Sunday of the Easter season, sometimes known as Low Sunday, after the very high celebrations of last weekend, Easter Sunday. Also, we call this Sunday Divine Mercy Sunday. You'll see the beautiful image there of the divine mercy of Jesus, the rays of his love and mercy and compassion flowing from his heart. That becomes a focal point of our worship today. I also want to welcome all of our young people to Mass. And just a wee reminder, there's no children's liturgy today, so the children remain with us for the entirety of the Mass. So as we come into God's presence then, we appeal to divine mercy, the mercy and the love of Jesus to wash our sins away. Let's call to mind those sins and ask the Lord to bathe us now in the rays of his mercy and his love. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You plead for us at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Thank you.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The whole group of believers was united, heart and soul. No one claimed for his own use anything that he had, as everything they owned was held in common. The apostles continued to testify to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus with great power, and they were all given great respect. None of their members was ever in want, as all those who owned land or houses would sell them and bring the money for them to present it to the apostles, and it was then distributed to many members who might be in need. The word of the Lord.
Israel say, his love has no end. Let the sons of Aaron say, his love has no end. Let those who fear the Lord say, his love has no end. The builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This is the work of the Lord, a marvel in our eyes. This day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and are glad. Alleluia.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Whoever believes that Jesus is the Christ has been begotten by God, and whoever loves the Father that begot him loves the child whom he begets. We can be sure that we love God's children if we love God himself and do what he has commanded us. This is what loving God is, keeping his commandments. And his commandments are not difficult, because anyone who has been begotten by God has already overcome the world. This is the victory over the world, our faith. Who can overcome the world? Only the man who believes that Jesus is the Son of God, Jesus Christ, who came by water and blood, not with water only, but with water and blood, with the Spirit as another witness, since the Spirit is the truth. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia. G Jesus said, "You believe because you can see me. Happy are those who have not seen and yet believe." Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. In the evening of that same day, the first day of the week, the doors were closed in the room where the disciples were for fear of the Jews. Jesus came and stood among them. He said to them, "Peace be with you," and showed them his hands and his side. The disciples were filled with joy when they saw the Lord, and he said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father sent me, so am I sending you." After saying this, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. For those whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. For those whose sins you retain, they are retained." Thomas, called the twin, who was one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. When the disciples said, "We have seen the Lord," he answered, "Unless I see the holes that the nails made in his hands, and can put my finger into the holes they made, and unless I can put my hand into his side, I refuse to believe." 8 days later, the disciples were in the house again, and Thomas was with them. The doors were closed, but Jesus came in and stood among them. "Peace be with you," he said. Then he spoke to Thomas. "Put your finger here. Look, here are my hands. Give me your hand. Put it into my side. Doubt no longer, but believe." Thomas replied, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "You believe because you can see me. Happy are those who have not seen and yet believe." There were many other signs that Jesus worked and the disciples saw, but they are not recorded in this book. These are recorded so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing this, you may have life through his name. The Gospel of the Lord. Now, the children did so well last Sunday helping me with the gospel and the homily. I think we should get them out to the front again. Out you come, boys and girls. Nice time off school or nursery?
Yes.
Now, boys and girls, hello. Boys and girls, last week we celebrated, of course, Easter Sunday. And tell me this, here is a very important question. How did the friends of Jesus, the disciples of Jesus, how did they know that he had risen from the dead? It's a hard question. Do you know, do you want to come to the front? You can tell us.
Because the tombstone rolled away.
Exactly, well done. Because the tombstone rolled away. Have you got an answer as well?
The angels came and...
You can come close.
The angels came.
Say it again.
The angels came.
The angels came. That is true. They saw an angel at the entrance to the tomb. Well done. Absolutely. But there's another reason they know that Jesus rose from the dead. You're getting a thumbs up here. Thumbs up? Yes.
She's only three.
She's only three and she's giving a thumbs up. Well done. There's another reason that they know that Jesus rose from the dead. There is another reason. And that is Jesus appeared to his apostles after he rose from the dead. And here's a question. How did they know it was Jesus? How did they know it was him when they saw him? Do you know? Come out to the very front and tell us. You tell us, how did they know?
Because there was holes through his hands and feet.
That's it, exactly. That's it. Well done, well done. The signs of the crucifixion were there. So the holes on his hands, where else? On his feet, and somewhere else, there was an injury somewhere else at his side as well. Exactly. So when they met Jesus after his resurrection, they knew it was him because they saw the wounds on his body. Now, in the gospel today, we hear that Jesus appears to his apostles, and they were all gathered in an upper room, and they were terrified. Why do you think they were scared? Why do you think the apostles were scared? Do you know, Kieran? Down you come. You can tell us. Why were they scared, do you think?
Jesus died, they thought that the Romans were going to come for them.
That's it, exactly. That's it, exactly. They were scared. They said, look what they did to Jesus on the cross. Maybe they'll come and get us. And so they locked themselves away in the upper room. And they were terrified. And then who comes to see them in the gospel today? Who comes in to see them?
I have a pink room.
You have a pink room?
Yeah, I love pink.
You love pink. Oh, that's nice. And purple as well. Well done. So who comes? Don't work with children or animals, they tell you in seminary. So who comes to see them in the room today? Who comes in to see them showing his hands and his side? Can you tell us? Come right up to the front. Tell us who comes in to see them.
Jesus,
well done. He does, he arrives. But one of the apostles isn't there. One of them's missing. Did we hear who was missing? You can come out.
Jesus.
Who was missing? One of the apostles wasn't there. Who was it?
Judas.
Oh, you're good. Judas wasn't there. Well done. Judas wasn't there. Well done. And there was another one that wasn't there. I was just testing y'all. Judas wasn't there. Who else wasn't there? Can anybody remember it was in the gospel today? Maybe Thomas could come down and tell us.
Thomas?
It was Thomas! Yes, it was. Well done. Thomas wasn't there. And all of the friends of Jesus, they meet up with Thomas afterwards and they say, guess who we just met? We just met Jesus. And he's risen. And Thomas says, unless I see him with my own eyes, and unless I can touch the wounds in his hand and his side, I'm not going to believe. Sometimes we call him Doubting Thomas, because he had doubts. He didn't fully believe. And then 8 days later, he appears again, and what does Jesus ask Thomas to do? Can you remember? We've got a lot of sleepy heads today. He says, Thomas, give me your hand and touch the wounds in my body. And then Thomas says, I totally believe. I totally believe. His doubts faded away, and he had tremendous faith in Jesus. Now, last thing I want to get you to have a look at. Can you see this big painting behind? Can you see it? Can you see it? It's a beautiful painting. That was painted in Poland for us. Who's in the center of it? Who's that there? Shout out if you know his name.
Jesus.
Jesus, exactly, Jesus. And see if you look at his heart. Have a look at his heart. What's coming from his heart? Can you see? Can you tell us? What's coming from the heart of Jesus?
It's shining.
That's right. And there are these lovely rays, and the rays that's coming from the heart of Jesus is his love and his mercy. And another word for mercy is forgiveness. See, when we do wrong, hands up if you've ever done wrong before. Is that about right? Well, will I start? I'll put my hand up, because we all do wrong sometimes. We all do things that are wrong. We all sin. And whenever we do something that's wrong, we come to Jesus, and the rays of his love and his mercy and forgiveness touch us, and Jesus always forgives us. Now, sometimes we get tired of asking for Jesus' forgiveness. Sometimes we get tired. Say that again.
You're super tired.
We've got a comedian up here this morning. Sometimes we get a bit tired of asking for the forgiveness of Jesus, but does Jesus ever get tired of giving us his forgiveness? No. And that's what we have to remember. Even if we're a bit like Thomas, and we have doubts, and we don't believe, and we struggle a bit in our faith, and we do things that are wrong, Jesus is always the one ready to forgive us, and to heal us, and to make everything right again. So we should never tire of saying sorry to Jesus or having the joy of the gospel like you do. Why don't we give the boys and girls a huge big round of applause? Well done, that's you. You want to head back down now? Well done, you can head back down. So now we stand as together we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Unlike Thomas, we are those who have not seen, and yet we believe. Because we believe in Jesus, who rose in our flesh to glory, we pray for others with trust in the God who listens. We pray that the Catholic Church may grow through continual proclamation of Christ's victory over death. Lord, hear us. We pray that the divine mercy may change the hearts and minds of people filled with hatred and conflict. Lord, hear us. We pray that those who doubt, like Thomas, may find faith in the one who was dead and who now lives forever. Lord, hear us. We pray that we may worship Jesus in the Eucharist with the words of Thomas, who said, "My Lord and my God." Lord, hear us. And we pray that the faithful departed may rise to share the glorious life of their risen Saviour. And we pray especially for those in our own parish who have died in recent times. May Jesus awaken them into the glory of new life. Lord, hear us. Father all-merciful, in his own body your Son rose to new life. Accept the prayers we make in his name. For he is the first and the last, the Alpha and the Omega, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and of those you have brought to new birth, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness. This we ask through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, "Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest." You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other a sign of that peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander the world for the ruin of souls. Amen. I notice a few faces from the 12 o'clock Mass. There must be something on later on today, I suspect. Okay, so just a wee reminder of a couple of things from the bulletin this week. It's a much shorter bulletin. The regular bulletin will start again, not next Sunday, but the Sunday after. So just a wee reminder that today being Divine Mercy Sunday, we have a whole programme starting at 3 o'clock with the chaplet, adoration and benediction, confessions and veneration of the image, and finishing with Mass at 5 o'clock for those who are able to join us. Everything else is as you see in the bulletin, and adoration starts back again on Monday tomorrow. Now also at the back of the church you'll notice that the new Fontes magazines, the diocesan magazines, they're available. So if you want to pick up one as you leave, they're free and they're available every 2 months. Now, last thing to mention is tomorrow, Father Towie and I, we're heading to Rome because Chris, our seminarian from the parish, is being ordained a deacon on Saturday. I see his very proud mum with us this morning. So on Saturday, he's going to be ordained a deacon in one of the great basilicas in Rome. So Father Towie and I, we just have to go out. You know, somebody has to do it. So we're delighted to be going and to support him. And we will carry your prayers and your love and your support to Chris. This is a big, big step for him when he enters ordained ministry now. And please God, sometime soon after that, he will be ordained a priest for our diocese, which will be a fantastic moment for our parish and for our diocese. Now, I was thinking about how we might offer a gift to Chris for his diaconate ordination. And I was thinking and thinking and thinking, and I think actually the best thing to do is probably just a monetary gift, and then he can decide what he wants to spend it on. He can convert it into pizza and pasta or whatever he wants. So, pizza. So, if at the end of the Mass, I'm going to put a bucket here at the front, a red bucket, for those of you who wish to contribute a wee gift to Chris for his ordination, if you just come up at the end of the Mass and just place that in there, and I'll convert it into euros, and I'll give it to him on behalf of the parish for his diaconate ordination. And I will see you not at the weekend, I'll be away, but I'll see you the following weekend after that. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.